wonderful to actually celebrate this in person in any capacity. So I appreciate you all being here, as well as people at home that are watching on the live stream. So just from the bottom of my heart, thank you for being part of this. It has been a year, and this project has really helped me get through so much, and just was a very high point for me, and I am so proud of the work that I've done with this. It is nuts to my own horn, but I think arguably the best work that I've done so far musically. So, but seriously, like, I could not have done it without the wonderful team behind me. Well, not physically, but you know. to my glorious musicians, Amy Tcheupdjian, who did cello, Dwayne Beach, who did viola, Candace Rembert, who did violin, and Carolyn Stallard, who did vibraphone as well as glockenspiel. Mallets on this thing. What? like, they just completely transformed my vision for this. This all started because every year, when it first snows, I have this tradition where I listen to Mauve Antarctica by Thomas Newman off of the Angels of America soundtrack. Because to me, that song just embodies what snow sounds like. And we were driving around last year, and I just had the thought while we were doing that, what if I wrote my own snow song? And so the idea for First Snow just kind of started creeping in, and I was like, I'm just gonna try to see what I can come up with for my own First Snow song. And thus we have First Snow. Snow Day was written with the idea of two children going through, finding out that they have a day off from school, they get to play in the snow, and you'll get to see that carried out through the dance very brilliantly. And then Blizzard, obviously you gotta have an angry track in all of this, so there's, you know, the treacherous blizzard that tears through the city, and then it ends with Stillness, which is the calm after the storm, and just kind of settling into the dead of winter and just letting all of those feelings happen. So on the album itself, there's also a bonus track called God Rest You Merry Carol Bells, which we'll listen to later. But it's a Christmas Carol mashup that I did a few years ago, but remixed because it's better. so I've gotten better at the production side of this. So those are the four tracks. The first four tracks we will see dances to. I also want to give a very special thank you to Ryan Van Slooten at Op Avenue Productions, who mastered this and listened to my relentless, but what if we did this small tweak, even though it's not very important, it is to me. And we fixed all the things and we got it right where it needs to be. There is not a single thing that I would change about this album, and that says a lot, because I'm a perfectionist, as many of you will probably attest to. Who else? Oh, I need to thank Jake King for shooting the album cover and also helping out with all this. And thank Izzy for also filming and helping out. Teresa, I love you. Your work is so brilliant, and I cannot wait for them to see it in a few minutes. And to all three of the lovely dancers, you all are also incredibly brilliant and have taken this on. And just, like, I watch this and I go, that's my music. Because nobody has ever done this kind of thing with my music before, and it just, not supposed to cry yet. it just really, you guys hit the nail on the head with everything that this album was supposed to feel, and I really think that it makes this whole experience even more magical and makes it even more special to me. So thank you to all of you. I'm going to shut up now, because I've talked for far too long. So without any further ado, I give you First Step. Thank you. Well, and I cried, so. You did your job. I thought if anybody, like if you guys want to do a short Q&A, if there's anything you want to know about either from the dance side or from the album side. Anybody? Cool.
I'm actually curious, choreographer's perspective, coming from the world she explained in the beginning and how she was inspired to do the music that she made, what was your process in terms of figuring out how to personify that with these beautiful dancers? Like, how did you connect with her to be like, I see what you're seeing? Because she said in the beginning, like, you hit it on the nail.
It spoke to me.
Yeah.
The music just spoke to me. I saw the story. It was very easy to choreograph.
Yeah.
That and I work with amazing dancers. It's a talent, you know? They know how to express themselves and use their own imagination. And they take direction very well. Yeah. So I was like, okay, this is what it is. I want to see a Mary Catherine. I want to see an Annette. And I want to see a Victoria. Do you? Let's see.
Yeah.
It just told the story. So that's what it was.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. Beautiful. Yeah. Was the use of the silhouettes in the video intentional? Like it, knowing that they were going to be performing in front of the video, like there was some silhouetting on the wall.
Wasn't
it
nice?
Cool. Yeah.
That was
very cool.
That was pretty nice. Yeah.
And it
was
even better when we added the lights.
Yeah.
Those were a last minute addition. But yeah, like I don't know, when I pictured this piece, I've always kind of seen it as like a film as art where it's like dance over top of this video. And like I've always known that I wanted to do a video for Stillness, just because it just invokes that part of me that's like, there needs to be something extra created for this. And like obviously I knew we were gonna have a dance to it as well. And, but we weren't entirely sure how it was going to look until we got here and played around with stuff. But like, I was watching it from the back and the silhouettes with the video was actually cool. So I'm really happy with how that turned out.
I have to say from a dancer's perspective, I think when they chose each of us, we were told that we weren't going to be the highlight of the music. We were going to be the background of the music, and that was the best part for us because we knew that what we were doing was just supposed to kind of be just something you were seeing in the background, but feeling everything through. So I think for us, we really took that to heart, and it was easy to do with the music.
Well, like this is the first kind of project like this that I've done. I've always thought it would be interesting to do film scoring, and I guess in a way that was also partly why I wanted to do a video for Stillness, because I was like, well, I've already written the music, so I can create a film to go with the music. But you know, just that idea of having a complete story for the songs and kind of take it away from, because normally I do a lot more commercial songwriting, where it's like, you know, verse, chorus, bridge, chorus, blah, blah. But you know, with instrumental music, it's like, there are no rules. And, I mean, technically, commercial songwriting can get away with not following any rules either, but with this, it's just even more, it's okay to have a 2-minute song, and it be complete, because it just feels right, and it doesn't, like, that was something that I found really difficult in writing. I kept wanting to fit into that 3.5 to 5 minute time frame, and I'm like, I don't have to. You know, I want to write for what the song needs to be. And so it was nice to be able to do that, and then dance come to it. It was just, I
Now you all made this just incredibly magical. Setting the tone was beautiful. Thank you all, that was phenomenal.
Being in it too, like with hearing the music, because it already brings so much emotion, and it really does, like, the whole, like, CD really does go through a full, like, huge arc. And so, like, being in that as well, I feel it, being in it and watching it from, you know, afar, and my, you know, my other dancers around with me, like, you know, we don't actually have to do much because it's already very much written in it. It's really much, it's really there. And so we don't need to be so busy because you've already done the majority of the work. So,
yeah. It also allowed us to go outside of our box a little bit.
Yeah.
I know from like day one where I was like, no, you really need to push them and be mean. And I was like, okay, then after a while, I was like, okay, we're doing this.
Yeah.
So it became a lot of fun. I think once we realized we could go outside of that box, we were really able to let go.
You were that tweak.
Aggressive. Yeah. It comes from direction. Not them.
You were so straight.
Album yet and would like to. I have physical copies. I also have download cards where you can scan it and it'll take you to the website where you can purchase it from any of your normal music streaming services. Spotify and Apple Music if you'd rather stream it. Fine. I think that's all. I think I'm going to shut up now. Go ahead.
God rest your cheer, 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 che